Hey yo, you ain't fuck me, you fuck the old body. My body out in Abu Dhabi.
Can I stop by? Do about anything, please, y'all. Come inside me, I'm a keeper. Want me to make you a seeker? Never been.
What's up, y'all? Today I'm going to be doing a look with products that are all under $20. People really be thinking that you need the most expensive stuff to get a good look, and you don't. Like, you really don't need to spend that much money, and I'm here to show you, so don't worry. So disclaimer, my hair, okay? You know, I really was trying something new with this little swoop thing, but it's not, you know, it's okay. But just disregard it if it's looking a little bumpy, if it's looking a little lumpy, if it's looking a little crusty. That's my business. But yeah, I just want to say that because I'm a little insecure about it. Please excuse my little mirror. Let me get the dust off this at least. So I'm just gonna start by doing my brows. There are no rules with makeup, okay? So you use what you got. So I'm gonna use black eyeshadow to fill in my eyebrows, and I pretty much always do that. And I only use like pomades and stuff when I'm going for a more natural look. But if I'm going for like a bold like look and I'm wearing eyeshadow and stuff, I'm just gonna use black eyeshadow. And if you just got a simple eyeshadow palette, you're gonna have black eyeshadow. If you don't have any eyebrow stuff and you don't feel like buying eyebrow stuff, use some black eyeshadow. But yeah, I'm gonna put some eyebrow pomades, gels, and pencils on the screen that you guys can buy from the drugstore as well. Also, don't sleep on the beauty supply store. They have really good eyebrow products too. Well, when it opens. Okay, next I'm just gonna shape up my brows with some concealer. This is the Maybelline Instant Age Rewind Eraser. It was $8, $7.99. But this is some good stuff. Next, I'm just gonna prime my eyes, but I'm just gonna do that with the Juvia's Place Concealer. You can do it with any concealer that you have, or you could get an eyeshadow primer. I have the NYX eyeshadow primer, but it's all right. So I'm gonna be using the Gorgeous Me palette that I talked about in my Amazon video. It's $18 and it's so good, and you get all these colors. So I just like to quickly dust a little bit of the lightest color in the palette, which is this. By the way, all the eyeshadow brushes I am using will be from Amazon, except for this one. I don't know where I got this from. I'm sorry. So I'm gonna go in with this shade here. When I'm working with bright colors, this is how I like to do it. Go put some, and I just like to pack it on right above my crease and into it too. Very lightly. Just blend out the edges, like I'm talking very lightly, barely even do it in small circular motions, but like I said, barely even do it. Okay, so I'm gonna take this yellow shade and I'm gonna go ahead and blend out these harsh lines, again using small circular motions. May have to go back in and do it a few times, like go dip in your yellow some more and go back and continue to blend, but it's all a process. Next, I'm gonna go back in with this pink, and I'm also going to dip it into this orange reddish color, and I'm going to go in the corners. Thank you. take this and I'm just going to, it doesn't have anything on it. I'm just going to go ahead and kind of like blend the pink and then the pink with the red. There we go. I'm gonna cut the crease and I'm gonna cut the crease using this Juvia's Place concealer. That only took me 20 years. I'm gonna start with this yellow shade that we were blending out the pink with. I'm only putting this on like the beginning of it, like the inner corner. I'm gonna go in and take this orange shade. I'm gonna put this orange on the rest of where the concealer is. Okay, so how to get this orange and this yellow to blend, I'm going to go back in with the brush that I was using for yellow. I'm gonna take a little bit of yellow. Now I'm gonna just go over that spot, that little line. And kind of swipe over. You can go in with a little bit of orange as well if you want. Just depends on how it's blended, and swipe over. Cause it doesn't have to be perfect. So at the end of the day, we're putting on lashes. Lashes fix everything. We're gonna take that same brush we put the pink and the red in. And we're gonna go ahead and dab. Just, I'm talking like, let me tell you, boom, boom. Like that's all you need. And we're gonna go back in those corners and just intensify it, but also just blend in the pink and orange. Making sure there's no harsh lines. And that's it. Boom. And we only used one palette. How good is that? Next, I'm just gonna put on some eyeliner. This was $3.61 from Target. But next, I'm gonna apply these lashes. So I'm using the lashes that I got from Amazon. They're in the style Dubai. They were in my Amazon video. You should check out my Amazon video. You should like this video. You should comment on this video. And you should subscribe to my channel. Mine's so dirty. But I envy Lash Glue, best lash glue, period. Got it from the Beauty Supply Store. I like this primer. I'm gonna use this primer today. This is from Maybelline. This is the Baby Skin Primer. I also like this primer too. I don't know what the top is, but this is the LA Girl Pro. This is the e.l.f. Matte Putty Primer, the little poreless primer that the world is going absolutely crazy over. Personal preference, but I like to spray my face with this Mario Bedescu spray. I just like to spray it on my face. I don't know why. I just like to before I do my foundation. It smells good. For foundation today, I'm using this L'Oreal Infallible Fresh Wear Foundation. Love this foundation. We can always get jiggy with the freaking Maybelline Fit Me, period, classic. Another good one is the Milani Conceal and Perfect Foundation. Bro, I love this foundation, but this is way too dark for me. This Maybelline Superstay is a good one too. This is mattifying, so if you like matte foundations, this is real good, real mattifying, and it has really good coverage too, and it lasts a long time. I'm real pale right now because I've just been sitting in the house and, you know, not getting no sun because we're in quarantine, but this one is good for me right now. And I'll just be, I don't know, I'll just be slapping on my face like this. This is, I mean, this probably isn't what you should do. Okay, so I'm gonna go ahead and conceal. I'm I'm gonna use my Juvia's place and just go around edges. I'm gonna just take a brush from Amazon. I'm going to blend out my concealer underneath my eyes with this brush as well. And I just like to use patting motions. Take this Revolution banana powder, got it from Ulta. They have different shades of powder, so if you have a deeper skin tone or if you're like lighter than me. It's not my favorite, but it's good and it's affordable. I used to contour with Black Radiance contour powder palette, but I lost it. I don't know where it is. So now I use this Juvia's Place Warrior, the Warrior 2 palette by Juvia's Place, because this brown is like perfect for me. I don't really contour. I bronze. I don't really cream contour unless it's something major or if I'm just feeling in the mood, but I'm usually not, so. Black Radiance has a really good contour palette. You can get it from like Walmart or Target, but I lost mine, like I said. So I'm gonna take a little bit more of this banana powder. And this is how we're gonna cut it, okay? I'm gonna cut the jawline to make it look more sharp. Well, you don't have to do this. I don't do it all the time. So now you can press that into the skin, but I'm not. I'm looking a little ghostly right here, right now, but when I spray it with setting powder, it'll be fine. So next, I'm going with some blush. This is the Milani blush. Everybody loves this blush. Like, people be going crazy over this blush. I've honestly never bought it. I did today, and this is $6.79. So this was about $7. I'm a blush freak, though. I love blush. So I don't like to just put it. I like to go ahead and pat it upward so it can give me that sculpt look.
Okay. Oh, this is real cute. Yes.
It is just so cute, y'all. Look at that. It's like a flower. I love it. Ooh, a little heavy-handed, but it's okay. I'm gonna do that little trim. People will be putting the blush on their nose. So I'm gonna go ahead and set my face. I'm using this Milani Make It Last setting spray. I love this setting spray. I bought it before, ran out, and I'm buying some more. This was $9 at Target, and it's real good. So I'm just gonna go ahead and set my face. Now spray some on my beauty blender, and then take my beauty blender and I'm gonna go ahead and press everything in. And I do this just to make sure everything lasts. And I also do this to blend out any harsh lines that I may still have, whether it's for my forehead contour, cause that'd be looking real harsh. So I blend that out. My blush and then my nose contour too. I kind of just press that in. Make sure everything is blended smoothly. Okay, so next I'm gonna go in with some highlighter. This is a Wet n Wild highlighting powder. This was like $4, I think. But it was a sale, so I got it 50% off. I had one, but it broke on me, so I got a new one. But this stuff is good. Like, let me tell you. Some of y'all ain't gotta, y'all, this is it right here. Highlighter, this is it. What color is this? This is Golden Flower Crown. Yes, honey. Oh my God, y'all see that? Oh my god, it's so pretty. And then it's like melts into your skin. Like, it's not just sitting on top of it, it's melting into my skin right now. So cute. I love this. Get this, bro. You don't get nothing. Get this highlighter. Like, get the highlighter. So next, I'm going to finish up my eyes. So I'm going to go my waterline with this Milk eye pencil. It's white. Jumbo eye pencil from NYX. And I don't like to go too ham with this, because if I go too ham with it, then it's going to start looking, it's going to look weird. So try to just be light-handed with this. If you're wearing eyeshadow, you always want to put something under your eye. So I'm taking this yellow shade, and I'm going to go ahead. Okay, so this yellow looks really like, it just doesn't, it's not doing it for me. I'm going to take the orange, and I'll put it under there too. I'm just go ahead and put some mascara on my top and bottom lashes, and this is the Wet n Wild mascara. Okay, so next I'm going to do my lips. Now I do not have a brown lip liner. I totally forgot while I was in Target I should have got one, but I got don't have a brown lip liner. That is from the drugstore. This is from MAC, and in order to stick with the theme, I am going to use what I got, and I'm going to use concealer to line my lips. I've done this before. I mean, it does the job. It's creamy, so it blends well. So next, I'm gonna take this lip gloss. I don't know this brand, but I know I got it from the beauty supply store. I wish I could remember the brand. I don't think it's Ruby Kisses. It might be though, but it was like $2. Okay, everybody, we have come to the end of this video, and this is the completed look. I love it. This is what I was going for. You know, I'm giving Starburst vibes, giving you real, you know, sunset. All the products I used were under $20. Most of them were under $10. All these products that I am using will be listed below in the description box. I hope you guys are inspired by this video and decide to pick up some of those products. And if you do, please let me know in the comments. I would love to know. So I hope that you guys enjoyed this video. Please like, comment, and subscribe to my channel. I would really appreciate that. Thanks for watching.